plenty of fish in the sea, right? Well, in a few years, there might not be. Around 70% of Earth's surface is covered in our oceans, and our oceans are one of Earth's greatest gifts. They provide things for people all over the world. Now, these seas that we're so dependent on might look healthy, but that is definitely not the case. There are changes happening within the depths of our oceans, on the surface, and people's persistent actions have damaged our oceans tremendously. But there are ways for us to reverse these damages and help bring our Earth and oceans back to optimal condition. We're going to be here for the rest of our lives, so making it a bigger priority to change our environment for the better should be more prevalent in our minds. Hi, my name is Summer Cook, and today I'm going to be talking to you about the importance of saving our seas and the animals within it.
You might see things on the news and on your social media about the reduction of our Earth's cleanliness, and this is a huge problem. Americans alone generate 10.5 million tons of plastic trash each year, and yet only 1 to 2% of it gets recycled. Now, around the world, around 14 billion pounds of trash are thrown into our oceans each year. This lack of cleanliness makes things incredibly hard for our marine life. So, for example, sea turtles. Sea turtles are animals who get their primary food source from jellyfish. Now, what is a form of trash in our oceans that look like jellyfish? Plastic bags. So these sea turtles eat these plastic bags thinking they're food, and obviously they're eating trash, which is going to make them sick. But consuming the trash isn't the only problem. Things like nets and plastic wrap get wrapped around sea animals' necks, fins, and tails, which can cut off circulation, making it impossible for them to swim, which in most cases leads to death. You mostly hear about the importance of picking up your trash on beaches and how much trash is actually in the ocean. But in reality, the trash in our oceans only takes up a small portion of the damage. Some other problems our seas are being faced with are our degrading coral reefs, rising ocean temperatures, carbon emissions, overfishing, and oil spills. January 4th of 2018, the Trump administration announced they were going to begin offshore drilling after America had put a pause on it back in 2016. Now, oil drilling is bad in more ways than one, and it overall doesn't have a lot of benefits. Plus, with our new technology, there are other ways for us to provide energy to the nation. Not to mention, most of America's oils are imported from other countries, so in a way, it's unnecessary for us to drill here. The true reason oil drilling is occurring is due to the fact oil companies are trying to make a profit. And offshore drilling brings in tons of money to big businesses. Now you might be asking yourself, okay, animals, oil, trash, but what about me? What about yourself as an individual in your community? Well, around 70% of Earth's oxygen actually comes from our oceans. It's produced by things like plankton and plants within the depths of our seas. But due to the rising ocean temperatures because of greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide produced by cars, factories, and more, it's killing off those plankton and plants, which is causing a drop in oxygen production. 97% of Earth's water supply comes from our oceans. So if this constant contamination continues, that percent will most likely drop in the upcoming years. Another factor is food. Due to the fact that the water is contaminated, a fish gets sick because of it, then that fish gets caught in a food supply haul, and it goes out to you, the people. And right then and there, you're eating contaminated food. So there are many factors that affect not only marine life, but you as well. Now, you've obviously probably heard of the circle of life. Everything is connected by simple strings. So if our oceans go away, the rest of our environment will fade with it, which is why it's so important for us to make a change in our lives and help save our seas and planet. Now, there are a lot of ways that we can achieve this. One big thing is to help reduce your carbon footprint. So instead of driving, walk or ride a bike. Plant your own garden or buy locally grown organic food. Try line drying your clothes instead of using a dryer. And of course, recycle. Things as simple as cleaning up our beaches, supporting organizations whose goals are protecting our Earth's oceans, and not purchasing products that exploit our marine life can really make a difference. If you take anything from my speech, I would just say, make sure you educate yourself on our Earth's oceans and the life within it. If we come together as a community and work together to make a change, we can keep our fish around a little longer. Now, I want to end my speech with a quote by a Japanese writer. Individually, we are a drop, but together, we are an ocean. Thank you.